right back in again. They're halfway through the Ranger power play, and New York hasn't even had an opportunity. Eakin just ran over Henrik Lundqvist in behind the net. I mean, blew him up. Nash tried to get at Eakin. The King has lost his crown, and
that's a rude welcome back.
Trying to get his faculties back.
VC was trying to catch Cody Eakin going up the ice also.
Antti Raanta is up and trying to get his gear ready. We'll see whether Lundqvist can continue on. He looked around, and man, he took a shoulder right to the head. I'll say this, with the concussion protocol in the league here now too, I mean, that's a direct hit to the head. I don't think Lundqvist, even if he feels like he's okay, is going to be allowed to continue. He shouldn't anyway.
With the spotters. Spotters should be in the building. And Cody initially, I think when he went around the wall, he just wanted to poke that puck loose.
There goes Lundqvist down the tunnel.
In front, and it will be cleared by Flynn, and Ott in behind the defense, reaching out, and a collision there as Ott slides into Bernier, and Bernier is hurt. We saw a collision against Pittsburgh. Jason Megna, Bernier got the best of that, but this one looks like he's in some difficulty as he collided with Steve Ott.
Yeah, hoping that he's just winded there, because Ott sold out trying to get the puck. Fresh ice, so he's going to slide right into Bernier. They're both diving for it as Bernier took the diving Ott right in the chest. You see Ott here stays onside, just out of his reach, dives for it, and rolls right into the crest of Jonathan Bernier. And the Leafs don't like it, but it's not a dirty play by Steve Ott. He's just trying to hook it back, and this ends up barreling right into him. Bernier up on his feet, looks like he's okay. As
might have even got the helmet right on the chin there.
Yeah, he rolled kind of up into him as they're just trying to protect themselves. And Steve Ott's not even looking at it. He's tucking his head and trying to protect himself. Bernier
thought about the knee right away, because that was what was injured in that collision in Pittsburgh that caused him to miss a start when it tightened up, but doesn't look like he's any worse for wear. James Reimer did stretch for a moment or two just in case.
Turnovers at a furious rate right now. Again, a drop pass. Duchesne, drop pass again. Good shot. Another collision with Lettinen. This time it's a Ginla, and he tattooed Kari, who's still down and hasn't really moved.
Well, Jerome Ginla comes into this, and he turns his back, and he just backs into Lettinen.
Dave Zeiss out to attend to Kari. With these hits, you can see Antti Niemi's getting ready to come back in. A lot of times that it's not even the trainer's decision. The spotter or the officials can pull even a goaltender from the game. Zeiss is in contact.
I've always wondered how they can pull him in this scenario, but even last game, we've seen about three of them ring off the goaltender's heads, and you would think that would be an opportunity too. And Jerome Ginla, after he drops his puck back, he goes to the front of the net, but he doesn't even try to slow his momentum down. And you know, after being in the league for so long, you know exactly where you are on the ice, and he just continues to back up and bowl Kari Lettinen right over. Kari's had a few of these past 2 years where he's gotten run over, and his head snaps back, and he ends up taking it a couple different ways and a couple different times.
We saw this when Henrik Lundqvist got rocked, and he went out, got evaluated, and came back in again. And I believe it was the same scenario where the Rangers were going on the power play because of the penalty to Eakin.
Olli Mäntä is back, and he's in a battle again, as these defensemen have been in the first few shifts of the game. He's playing with Steve Oleksi on the blue line. He's just into the lineup, and the Leafs are after the puck. Chris Kunitz, veteran left winger, gets it. He's got Hornqvist on the right side, and Bonino is the center.
Fleury's hurt here. He got a stick in the face. I wonder if it went through his mask or got him underneath. He's bleeding, actually.
This has happened to him before.
This one did underneath, and it was James Van Riemsdyk who was battling in front. So all of a sudden, Matt Murray's going to have to come into this game. Watch the play right around the net. Was it a stick or a skate? Oh, it was a skate, yeah. Too. That's why the cut. I thought it was a stick initially, as no fault of Van Riemsdyk, but the skate went right underneath the mask. And even Fleury has that protector. You see the plastic clear protector there, but that skate just went right up underneath, and there's Matt Murray. He's going to have to get ready.
They're going to try, it seems, to keep him out here and see if they can patch him up and get him back in and stop the flow of blood.
Well, how fortunate that it wasn't worse. I mean, you think of how quick that skate is coming up. Oh, yeah, it looks like it just jabbed him as opposed to slicing him across.
It doesn't look like they're going to be able to do it at the bench, so they're taking him to the dressing room.
Well, you think back to some horrific moments, most notably the Clint Malarchuk in Buffalo. And so Matt Murray thinking he's got a night off after a heck of a game last night. Overtime 1-0 loss for these Pittsburgh Penguins.
Potvin as well. Bourne went to the boards. Coffey holds it in. Gave it to Curry. Curry is shot. Blocked by Morrow. And Fifth has been knocked into the back of the goal. Who was it? Lumley that went after him? They got the eye on Lumley. He's gone to the dressing room. He just pushed Wally Harris as well. Smith went down heavily. Now, whether or not Billy Smith, we know, is a good actor, whether or not he was really hammered, we were watching Gary Curry at the blue line with the puck. Semenko talks to Billy Smith. Lumley is headed for the Edmonton dressing room. Let's take a look, see if we can see what happened. There's Billy Smith as he falls. There's Lumley right in front. He speared him. Penalty for spearing assessed to Dave Lumley at 19:24.
Picking his way slowly to center, Messier hands it in on the left wing to Anderson. Billy Smith was hit hard by Anderson. Smith flat on the ice, getting up slowly.
He's hurt.
He seems to be hurt. Bossy is in. The play is called. Billy Smith has been injured.
Well, hopefully we'll have a replay of this. It happened, Dick, a little bit behind the play,
right.
And I'm not sure who it was. I think it was Glenn Anderson that went in. And if we do have another look at it, we maybe see what happened. Anderson, with that great speed, came in the left side. Van Helleman didn't make any move at all to call a penalty. Back on his feet in the front.
Coffey knocks it around behind the net for Messier. Out in front of backhander from Anderson and over the net. He dropped the stick around and Smith goes down. Theatrics, the referee, making a gesture. And that's Anderson, I believe, that's taken it. Or is it Coffey? There will be a penalty against Edmonton.
Anderson, I believe, caught Billy Smith around the net. It's not necessary. He hasn't made contact. I think he swung back right there. Missed Smith. Billy Smith was not touched. And look at the theatrics. I guess if you can get a penalty to the opposition for doing it, so much the better. Somehow.
Tag team there at the boards, but it's been right in front of the net, and they crash into Vera. As John Mitchell took a Senator player in, it looked like Turris, and Vera has been shaken up. Varlamov is on the DL as of earlier today. And Reto Vera still hasn't moved.
There's Calvin Pickard, the backup goaltender tonight, a former first-round pick by the Avalanche. Flew all day today as he's been playing in the American League with Lake Erie. Played this past weekend. Played very well in the season opener. Had a shutout on the road. And Reto Vera is the starter. He's the only, I guess he's not even really experienced, as he gets steamrolled by Kyle Turrison with Varlamov on the shelf. It looked like Patrick Waugh was going to have to lean on Reto Vera here.
Unless he's next up.
I don't know if Patrick's still got pads. But he's not very happy that there's was not a call made on the play. Turris drove the net. And there was some contact with the Avalanche defenseman. As he gets to the front of the net, Turris makes a strong move. There's the poke check. But you see John Mitchell actually drives Turris back towards Reto Vera, who ends up in the back of the net.
And you could see the head contact there. Vera
starting to get up and trying to collect himself here, but you would think that this long to get to his feet, he'd at least have to go through some concussion protocol.
Well, he's coming out of the net, and so whatever the day looked like for Calvin Pickard, it's changed in a big hurry.
Foligno dumps it in front of the net. Ennery, too many passes on the play. O'Reilly tried to get it back to Foligno, and the goaltender Gustafson is down on the ice, and he's been injured.
Great opportunity for the Buffalo Sabres on this 2-on-1. And not able to capitalize. You see Gustafson staying down on the ice. The trainer's out there to help.
I didn't see what happened to him, did you?
He was just driving through to the net. He got fallen on by a player driving through. Here's Marcus Foligno. He's with Ryan O'Reilly. Beautiful pass. Ryan O'Reilly had Gustafson down out, and he tried putting the puck back to Marcus Foligno. Shoot the puck right here. He's got the whole net, and he tried sliding it back to Marcus Foligno. But you see number 6 for the Edmonton Oilers.
Adam Larson
falling on top of Gustafson. And he's still laying face down on the ice with the trainer.
It looked like he jammed his neck.
Blues went right to him, and Muller comes away with it with a pass for Clark. Domi up on the play. Clark over the line. Shoots. Casey the save. Domi couldn't get the rebound. Now McGinnis cleared it to the corner. Muller lays it to the side of the net. John Casey down. Thanks to Wendell Clark. Referee's arm in the air. Another late penalty call coming.
Wendell was strolling through the crease and knocked Casey down, and he'll get the penalty. Casey gave Wendell a shot, and then Wendell returned the favor, and the referee McCurry put his hand up. Who was the penalty to? I don't know, but let's have a look. Wendell takes a shot, and then Wendell gives him a cocoa bump in the back of the head. Now, did the referee see both or not?
I don't think so.
Center and flips it in. Oh, and Harding gets run over, and there's going to be a penalty. They blow the play dead, and there's going to be a penalty against the Predators, and looks like there might be more. Stoner jumps to Harding's defense.
And don't even want to consider what happens if Harding goes down, because then the Wild have to dress one of their defensemen. He gets swept as he goes to get the puck. Stoner jumped in there very quickly. Watch the play at the side of the net. Harding out there, but kind of gets steamrolled. Kloon, of course, in a fight earlier with Konopka, and right there, not really doing anything to really avoid Josh Harding. Harding was kind of putting up a bit of a wall to try and block the forecheck.
So there was a penalty coming at that point. The official's arm had gone up. You would figure the rest of it would probably even out, but we'll wait and see.
Well, there goes the lack of physical play in this game.
Penalty killer along with Claude Loiseau for Detroit. North Stars moving out of their own zone. Here's Smith carrying out center ice. Fett on the right side. Smith's pass broken up by Schoenfeld. Steffen came out of the goal. Schoenfeld and Platt. Then Steffen. Oh, and Platt. Oh, he scored. Willie Platt actually brought the stick right across the back of Steffen's head and knocked him right to the ice.
I've never seen a player do that. He just turned around coming from behind the net where Steffen had made a play on the puck along the boards. And Willie Platt just lost all control, and he come on chopped the two-hander right across the back of the goaltender Greg Steffen's head. A tough way for the rookie to break in, I'll say that.
One of the Red Wings is on the pileup. That I didn't see.
Well,
he took right after Platt and has him right on the bottom of the pile right now as the linesman pulling him off. It was John Barrett. He didn't waste a second. He had Platt.
Well, I've never seen a player do just that. You see a lot of things
Steffen
happen.
Steffen did take a little jab.
Well, it's that's just left. Contact along the behind the boards on a loose puck along the right along the glass and along the boards. Stefan was trying to get it in the corner to John Schoenfeld. Plett played the body, knocked him down. Stefan took a little chop, but he really got a two-hander back. Now, whether the referee saw it or not, if he ever sees the tape, he'll know.
I'm going to tell you something. You talk about the shot that Dennis Polonich took from Will Famont. This was more.
Oh, yes, definitely. This was a deliberate two-hand chop right across the back of the player, the goaltender's head, and thank goodness he had a helmet on.